Voters of Tampines, how are you tonight? Voters of Singapore, how are you tonight? Supporters of NSP, how are you tonight? My name is Kin Lian. I am not contesting this general election. I am here to give support to my good friend, Go Meng Seng, Gilbert Goh, and the NSP team contesting in Tampines GRC. Now, some of you know me, and Meng Seng has just introduced. I was the chief executive of NTUC Income Insurance for 30 years. You were my policy holders, so tonight I'm here to say thank you for your support. I want to address my fellow citizens who will be contesting, who will be voting on 7th of May in all constituencies around Singapore. Not only Tampines, but all around Singapore. This general election will be a watershed for Singapore. More than in previous election, the outcome will have a great impact on the future for us, for our children. It is important that all voters in Singapore think over the issues carefully and cast your votes wisely on 7th of May. During the past 5 years, many citizens have to struggle with rising cost of living, stagnant wages, long working hours, crowded transport, competition with foreigners for jobs, and a stressful life. Do you agree with me?
Yes!
Raymond Lin says MRT trains are crowded. Now I know because I also travel MRT train. Now, morning the trains are packed. That's alright because there are too many people.
Mad rush transport, MRT.
But let me say, when I go back home, 10 o'clock at night, from Raffles City to Yio Chu Kang, the trains are packed all the way. Packed all the way. And why? Because SMRT in the evening put less trains. They want more profit. Now, if you want a more comfortable life, you need to have in Parliament more people like Go Meng Seng and more people wearing orange. Now, many citizens were disappointed that the problems that they face were not adequately addressed by the government until election time. And then election time, Prime Minister realized the problem. So what happened to the elected MPs that were supposed to represent you? Did they bring up your problems in Parliament?
No!
Now, this general election will give you the chance to change the situation and elect members of Parliament who have the time to listen to you and understand the issue you face day by day. And they will be able to bring your voice into Parliament. This is very important. Do you agree? Now let me tell you this. You do not need, as your MP, a government scholar. You do not need a top corporate manager. You only need an educated person who is honest, interested to serve the people, have a heart, and have ears, can listen, and is able to think independently. Do you agree? Now we have some examples of good MPs. Mr. Jiang Sitong. Mr. Lau Kia Kiang. We know it is very difficult to be an MP from the opposition. But they work tirelessly. They spend a lot of time with their residents. They look after their residents, their voters. And this is why election after election, in spite of no upgrading, who do the voters vote for? They vote for Mr. Jiang and they vote for Mr. Lau. This is the type of MP that you must vote for. There are many candidates in this election, people younger than me. These are passionate people, interested to serve you, and willing to take up the job of MP as the primary or the full-time job. Yeah. Some of them have pledged that if you elect them, they quit their job to serve as MP full-time. I want you, the residents of Tampines, the voters of Tampines, the voters all over Singapore, give them a chance. You hear them at election speeches, you watch them on YouTube, on the internet, you know what they are, you know how they feel for the people. Now I want to talk about the next government. The people that will come into government after 7th of May. The candidates you vote, and I'm talking about all over Singapore, in the election, the candidates you vote will determine who forms the government. There are three possible outcomes. Number one, the PAP win nearly all of the seats. They continue to dominate government and the style of government remains the same as before. Is this what you want? The second outcome, the opposition parties can win a few GRCs, a few SMCs, maybe Tampines. When the opposition are in parliament, they will put pressure on the government to change their policies that are bad for the people. They will get the government to give priority to Singaporeans. Do you want this?